The ocean is a vast and complex ecosystem that is home to millions of species. It covers more than 70% of the Earth's surface and plays a crucial role in regulating the planet's climate and weather patterns. One of the most fascinating creatures that inhabit the ocean is the octopus. In many ways, the octopus is as close to alien life as we may ever see. Few creatures in the world are as remarkable and bizarre a part of a class of animals called cephalopods. They are among the most intelligent and most mobile of all the invertebrates. These intelligent and adaptable creatures live in various parts of the ocean world, in the deep sea, in kelp forests, in coral reefs, along rocky shorelines. And they are as diverse as the habitats they live in. Octopuses come in a range of shapes, sizes, and colors. The smallest species, the California two-spot octopus, is less than an inch long, while the largest, the giant Pacific octopus, can grow up to 16 feet in length and weigh more than 100 pounds. Some species, such as the mimic octopus, are known for their ability to mimic the appearance of other animals, while others, such as the blue-ringed octopus, are highly venomous. In any given moment, they can appear spiky or they can appear smooth. They are so different from us that most of their 500 million neurons are not in their brain, but in their arms, which can smell and taste and even think, and so intelligent that their cognitive ability matches that of many large brain vertebrates. They have left scientists stunned about how a creature so far from us on the evolutionary tree could evolve such complex behaviors, their intelligence emerging in an entirely novel and independent way from our own. So how did the octopus become so biologically complicated, an island of complexity in the sea of invertebrate animals? Just how intelligent are they? Octopuses belong to the family of cephalopods, which includes squids and cuttlefishes. Cephalopods have been around for a long time. Fossil records show that they evolved over 500 million years ago, long before any fish, reptiles, or mammals ever appeared on Earth. The early ancestor of the octopus was quite small and had a shell which it used to protect itself as it crawled along the ocean bottom. They are characterized by their soft bodies, large heads, and tentacles. Octopuses are invertebrates, which means that they do not have a backbone. There are around 300 species of octopus. Survival of these soft-bodied creatures for so many millions of years, therefore, seems unlikely in a sea full of dangerous, hungry predators. But this vulnerability and selective pressure may be precisely what has allowed the octopus to become the remarkable creature we know today. Because an octopus has almost no hard parts at all except its beak, it can squeeze through any hole as long as it's larger than its eyeball. This allows the octopus to hide in very small crevices, a certain evolutionary advantage when escaping large predators like sharks or dolphins. But the soft-bodied octopus evolved an even more clever way of evading detection. They are masters of disguise. Watching this clip of an octopus, you can see just how quickly and drastically it can change colors in slow motion. Reverse, you see the color change spread across its body. The 3D texture of the skin also changes to match the surrounding seaweed and coral. In the blink of an eye, it has almost completely blended in with its surroundings. Cephalopod camouflage is among the most dynamic in the animal kingdom and relies on a system of extremely sophisticated tissues. Chromatophores are organs that are speckled across the skin of the octopus. Like freckles, they contain tiny pigment-filled sacs, like little balloons full of different colored dye, which can be black, red, or yellow. The pigment sacs are surrounded by radial muscles, which can stretch the sac to reveal the pigment's color. Just like balloons full of dye, when stretched, their pigment color appears bright and vibrant. Depending on which sets of sacs an octopus opens or closes, it can produce patterns such as bands, stripes, or spots, helping to turn itself into a rock, a coral, or a kelp in an instant. But if the octopus needs to produce colors outside of black, red, and yellow, it uses another layer of reflective structures in their skin called iridophores. They are stacks of very thin cells that lay beneath the chromatophores. They contain a protein called reflectin that bounces certain wavelengths of light back out. They are responsible for the metallic blues and greens that appear to shimmer on the skin of the octopus. Beneath that layer is yet another layer of reflective tissue called lucophores. These reflect ambient light, usually producing white hues. By combining reflection from the iridophores and lucifores with the correct patterning of the chromatophores, the octopus can create a very convincing copy of its surroundings. But the octopus has one more trick up its sleeve, allowing it to disappear in plain sight almost completely. Using a structure called papillae, it can change the texture of its skin, creating ridges and bumps that rise and fall. This helps the octopus match its surroundings even better. With all these tools, the shell-free, soft-bodied octopus has been able to deceive an ocean full of predators for millions of years. Thanks for watching. To watch more videos like this, subscribe our channel.